Hey, what's going on, guys? Kurosama here. Now, today we're taking a look at a pretty special Robot Damashii figure. And I know this is a little bit different than what I normally review, which is some figures like the Gundam Universe line, or just straight up Plamo. This is a Robot Damashii, a more competent and probably like a better received figure line. And they're usually in the 1 to 144 scale. So this one in particular is going to be a review on the Yokohama Walking Gundam RX-78F00, or I'm pretty much gonna call it Foo, like Foo Fighters. Now what makes this Gundam special is not only what it's designed based on, it's based on the Walking Gundam. That's pretty significant. But also, you can only get this Gundam or this figure over at the site. So you have to go to Yokohama and that's where you gotta purchase it. But if you're like me and you physically cannot go there because of COVID, because there's a lot of restrictions, I can't actually go there. And it's like a hop and a skip away. It's literally frustrating every single moment that I exist here. But I was able to get it off of Yahoo Auctions. I'm not sponsored by Yahoo Auctions, and if I were, I probably wouldn't give them that much of a positive rating because the user interface on Yahoo Auctions, it frustrates me, all right? And it is just troublesome to navigate, in my opinion. But I do have a sponsor, and they are called NewTypeHQ.com. They are a fantastic site. I love everything about the site. I love the people that work there, and you know, it's just a great place if you want to get some model kits of your own. Now, I know this doesn't sell there, but if you do want an RX-78 of your own, they do have plenty of those. So make sure you stop on by the shop and use that promo code KROSAMA, so that way you can get 10% off your purchase. Alright, so let's go ahead and get on to the review. Now before I even get into the review, I'm going to go ahead and tell you guys what the price is. But I'm not going to tell you what the retail is, because it doesn't matter. You'll probably never find this at retail unless you go to the site. And if you go to the site, hey, you're going to get it for a good, you know, pretty good price. But anywhere else, you're probably going to pay over $90. I paid about $90-$95 for mine. That was including shipping. So I paid quite a handful to get this and the stage over to my place. But I'm very stubborn and probably a little stupid because I really wanted this and I paid top dollar in order to get it. So was it worth it? That's pretty much the question. And that's actually the question that I had to think about a while. Is it worth it? So let's go ahead and answer that in this this review. So starting off with the box. Honestly, they look fine. There are going to be two of them, and we're just going to focus on the Gundam first and not the actual stage, but they look fine. Now straight out of the box, you are going to have quite a few accessories, but it's not as much as the, I think, the version anime. That, I think that has a little bit more that comes with it, including like thruster effect parts. This one doesn't include thruster effect parts, but you can use like version anime thrusters for this. So if you do want to plug them in, the thrusters on the back can actually do that. Now for details, honestly, it looks great. It's only missing like some color application here and there, but it does have the gray on the white, which is great because if it was all just completely white, I'll probably be a little irritated. But the gray breaking up the white looks really good. It just doesn't have a lot of the stuff going on for it on the chest, which I guess is a little bit understandable. It's a 1-144 scale, but I would have loved a little bit more. And it is going to have all those nice little panel lines, so if you do want to panel line this thing, hey, you could definitely go ahead and do that. Now for articulation, this figure actually does have quite a bit of articulation. I was thoroughly surprised to see just how far the arms and the legs and everything can move. The waist is pretty good, can move around, and yeah, I really have no problems with the overall movements and posability of this figure. Even the ankles, I mean, the ankles can move side to side fairly well, so I'm pretty satisfied in that department. Now let's talk accessories. You are going to get a peace sign hand, two open hands, two closed fists that you can actually plug accessories in, a pointing finger hand, two trigger hands, an extra V-fin, two beam saber effect parts, and a beam blast effect part, which doesn't really look any different than a beam saber, except for it's a little bit fatter. Now the overall amount of accessories that this figure is going to come with, I think is okay. I just, man, I really wish it would have came with a little bit more. But besides that, let's go ahead and take a look at the weapons. Now let's take a look at the beam rifle. Honestly, it looks pretty good, no issues, has a little bit of articulation, and it performs exactly how you would think it does. Goes into the trigger hand, and it's a beam rifle. Now for the shield, it can plug directly into the forearm, which is really good, and you can have some pretty solid poses. Or you can plug it directly into the hand, but it can't plug into the hand and the forearm at the same time. You pretty much are going to have to choose what your position is going to be. Now it can also plug directly into the back, so if you want some of them poses with the shield in the back, you can definitely do that as well. It's also going to come with a stand adapter, so that way you can plug it directly underneath the mobile suit, and you can plug it into a stand and, you know, do some aerial poses. Now for the G-Dock, honestly, it looks great. I'm still kind of puzzled as to why they were sold separately. I think it would have been better if they were just sold as a bundle, but maybe there was a future plan or something like that. But I don't know. I don't know what Bandai's thinking whenever they went ahead and split both of them. I definitely would have liked them all in just one package instead of having to try and, you know, sell or try and buy these as a set, because I did actually get two extra sets. And I sold one set, but the other set I am having problems trying to sell. So, I don't know, man. I really wish it was just a bundle. Overall, though, I think the G-Dock looks fine. It has a lot of articulation. It also has some areas on the back to where you can rest the beam rifle and you can rest the shield on the back. You could plug in the actual mobile suit directly into the stand that's on there, and you can move the stand back and forth, the entire dock back and forth, as if you're simulating what you see at Yokohama. It looks great. Honestly, I love the looks of it together, but, man, when I get into my final thoughts, I'm going to be very, very conflicted on how to address this. So, with that, let's get into the final thoughts. How do I address this? Well, on one hand, I could say that because it's limited, because it's like, you know, a very special event type of mobile suit, maybe I can waive the fact the price is going to be grotesque in the aftermarket. And usually an aftermarket price doesn't dictate much of the kits or figure it's worth. You know, I can say, hey, because the aftermarket says it's just say $200. What does that still say about the figure? You know, I could say, well, at its retail, it would be this, and at the aftermarket, it would be this. But I'm just going to be a realist here. Most, like 99% of Gundam fans outside of Japan are not in this current state of the world going to be able to go to Yokohama and pick this up. And chances are you're not spending the money to just go and pick this up. You're going on vacation, doing other things, and this just happens to be a bonus. So I'm actually going to speak to the individuals that are looking at proxying a service like Buy or something in order to get this product, well, both products. So my final verdict, the details are great. The accessories leaves a little bit to be desired, in my opinion. But they're still fine. You just get a bunch of hands. The peace sign hand's a little bit weird. The pointing hand is kind of like iconic to what it is. And that's kind of how I have the Chogokin one. That's the pose I have it in. For this one in particular, you know, I'm just going to have it in a normal standing pose, probably walking. It looks good. It looks great with the base as well. I think the base definitely replicates the look of the base at Yokohama. But chances are you're not going to be able to find this for less than like $110. Me being in Japan and using, you know, Yahoo Auctions, I still paid a good pretty penny for this. And I can only imagine what people like in the UK, Australia, United States, or anywhere else, I can only imagine what they're going to be paying for this. Probably a lot more, to be honest. Unless they have a buddy hook them up. I'm going to have to say it's a drop it. Yeah. I would say it's a definitive drop it. And it really, I really don't want to say that because to me, it was an instant cop it because I really liked the design. I could say watch it, but how long are you really going to try and scope out a good price for this? How much money are you willing to spend to try and get this? I would say it's not a $100 worth figure, to be honest. That's just my personal opinion. And I know I'm even trying to sell one to make even. I'm trying to break even on the third one I bought by selling it for about $100, between $100 and $110. But in all good faith, I can't tell you, the viewers, that this is something you should go out and buy with your hard-earned money. You know, it was a lot easier to buy the P-Bandai high-grade one. And in fact, it still is just a better buy overall. Granted, you have to, build it and you have to paint it. It doesn't even come with decals, to my knowledge. It doesn't come with anything, really. So you are at a little bit of a disadvantage, but at least you're going to be saving close to about, $60, maybe even $70 if you just get the high grade and not the Robot Damashii. This really caters to individuals that are going to be able to make it to the Yokohama site. I wasn't fortunate enough, so I just was dumb enough to go ahead and spend a grotesque amount of money for this figure and stand. Maybe some people will disagree with me, which is fair, but I think in my stance, I would have to say just drop it, unless you come across it and it's a really good price, like maybe less than $80, maybe $70. I would say, somewhere between probably like less than $70, maybe even less than $80. That's a good price range to try and get this. Otherwise, I really, in all good faith, can't say get this thing. That's all I really have to say about this figure review. I do hope you enjoyed it and you got to, got a better idea about the Foo and how it looks. And if you can't go to the site, then maybe in the future events, Japan would open up a little bit more and people would be more accessible to come over and experience it. For me, I don't know, man. It doesn't look very very bright in my future to go and see it, just because of the way that the military is with all those locations, and Yokohama is pretty much a red zone for us. So maybe one day I'll get to see it. I saw the previous two statues. I saw the unicorn, took a picture with it, and I seen the original RX-78-2 back in, 2011. So I like to go ahead and get a photo with this and be able to put it on my wall. Other than that, guys, that's pretty much it. Go ahead and leave a like if you did enjoy this video. Subscribe if you haven't already, because I think about 67% of y'all are not subscribed. So if you're watching these videos and you are not subscribed, I do encourage you to go ahead and hit that subscribe button and just hang out with us and enjoy the videos. Otherwise, thank you all for watching, and thank you all to the members who sponsor this channel. And I'll be seeing you in the next review. Bye-bye.